so here we are, Sylvia and Mike, back again for Rumba instructional video number 3.
Look at me.
Right? 3. So what we just did was a run through of all the steps we've covered so far in the first 2 videos, with the addition of 2 steps that we're focusing on today. We're going to break down in just a minute, and those steps are the crossover break and the crossbody lead. Right? So we're going to get into what those look like. First, we'll dance it together a couple of times from different angles, and then we will break down the lead and follow of each of those steps. At the conclusion, we'll dance everything through again to music. So if you haven't seen the first couple of videos in the Rumba series, you want to go back and look at those, and we'll show you those other steps leading up. Well, they're on the Facebook page for the Y.
Yes? Okay.
So, and they may be posted elsewhere as well. So first of all, the crossover break. And I think the reason for that title will be evident when you see it. So we start just as we would a regular box, with a slow, a side together, and then one more step headed in this direction. Slow. At this point, we begin to open up, and we're going to bring this arm through for a quick face one another on the slow, quick, slow, and we end with an underarm turn.
And guys, slow, you have to get your arms
quick,
up there.
Quick. So all together, slow, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, and quick, to set up for the next step. Okay, so the guy's part, the lead's part, forward with the left foot for slow, quick, close on a quick, slow to the side, come through, quick, replace weight, right? So, maybe hard to see that clearly, but we're going forward quick, back quick, and then turning to face the partner on the slow. Then we do the same thing to the other side. All right, I'll bring this arm through and open up the left arm. So, quick, slow. We do it one more time to the leader's right. Quick, slow. On that slow, the hand comes up, which tells the follower, as we know, a turn.
Sure.
Quick, slow. So essentially the follower's part, as in most of the steps, is a mirror image of what the lead is doing. Anything else to add?
No,
to that?
Just put your arms out there.
All right, so we'll show that one more time straight through without any stopping. Let's do it from this angle. Yes. Slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, quick, slow, quick, and you can see we can then move into the next step, right? Okay, we're checking the video to make sure it is progressing as it ought to be.
Yes.
It is. Okay, so that is crossover break.
This next one's a little bit more difficult.
The second step we want to show you is crossbody lead. Crossbody lead can be a little bit more difficult. It's a very important step in a number of dances. Pretty much every dance, if not literally every dance, has some version of a crossbody lead. And in Rumba, as in other Latin dances such as cha-cha, it's often a linking step. So you will do one pattern or step and then use a crossbody lead to set up going into the next step. It's a beautiful step on its own because it changes the position of the partners. So when we complete this one crossbody lead, you'll notice that Sylvia will be facing where I am, she'll be where I am and facing that way, and I'll be facing this way. So let's show it and then we'll break it down. Slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick. So notice we ended with the completion of a box step, which is often the case in Rumba steps. One more time from this angle. Slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick. Okay, so this is one of the steps in which there is definitely different things that lead and follow are doing, the leader and the follower are doing. So the leader's part begins with the first part of the box. Slow with the left foot, of course. Quick, quick. So far it's just, this is a half a box. On the second slow, the leader steps back on the right and begins to torque his body. So it's a little bit of an angling. The frame remains facing the partner, right? So we don't want to twist funny. And we certainly don't want to lurch back. It's just same spacing as a regular box, only quick, quick, starting to turn. And also starting to apply a bit of pressure to the follower's shoulder blade. So again, she knows this is not just a box, right? Once she's done this a couple of thousand times, she knows, crossbody lead. So slow, quick, quick, slow. The leader then does a side together, quick, quick, right? On pretty much a straight line, slow, quick, quick, slow. I'm opening the door, as a teacher once told us some years ago, for the follower to walk through on the quick, quick. Then the leader steps forward with his left, slow, quick, quick, and is back into a box step. Slow, quick, quick. So without too much talking there, let me show it again. Slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick. And notice there's not a whole lot that I'm doing differently with the arms. Okay, I'm applying pressure to the contact point on the shoulder. Some leaders like to drop this hand as a way to give a further lead. It's not really necessary to do that. If you're moving from your center, when you do that shift, the lady is going to pivot, as we'll see, right? So the follower's part probably is a little bit more challenging because it does involve a pivoting on the second quick. So can you show that? You want to just walk it through? You want me to do it with you?
Yes, okay. I like to be led.
Okay, so let's do it from this side, which will feature the follower's part, right? Slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick. So you notice the pivot on the second quick. That's probably...
And you got to get past.
That's the tricky element to this step for
right.
the follower.
Right, if you're hopping and you're still right here with him, it's not going to work.
Right. So let's do it again, and I think this is definitely the angle you want to see it because you can see the follower here. So slow, quick,
quick,
quick.
Forward
slow.
My left foot, right foot, pivot, there. So you pivot on your left foot coming out.
Yeah. So it's really a matter of just repetition. If you're practicing this, if you try it and you find it a little bit confusing, keep watching it and just keep practicing it. You have to get it into the muscle, right?
Yeah, you gotta make sure that the leader is, okay, do it where you would block.
Yeah, the leader, that's an important lead point. The leader really needs to
stand out
of the way because we don't want the follower having to jump around. So not this, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, right? Or even just, that was obviously exaggerated, but it's not uncommon when you're learning this particular pattern to not get sufficiently to the side to allow a nice clean walk.
Or they
through.
Go too fast, so all of a sudden they're there, but they're not waiting for you to go out on your foot.
So gentlemen, we do not want the lady to have to jump around us, right? Especially if we should have a more expansive frame, right? We need to take that into account, that we need to remove the full body so she can pass through, right? Slow, quick, quick, slow, out of the way. Quick, quick, slow, quick, quick. Now just one other lead point.
And also if you are pivoting, say you're gonna go to, we're gonna pivot, you don't do this. You're not swinging your leg out. It stays close to your body.
Yeah, show that. Pay attention to that. So yeah, the legs are kept very close together. It's almost like an ankle, as if the ankles are connected. Slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick. And generally with most of these dances, certainly true of rumba, but also the other dances, we always have a tendency when we're learning to exaggerate the step. Like we think we have to step big. Usually not, especially in Latin, often the smaller the step, the better it is. And of course, the faster the music, the more critical that is. The other thing I think we want to emphasize with both of these steps, it's very easy, it's very tempting to rush through the slows. That's a general concern about rumba anyway. We don't want to rush through the slow. Slow is to be. Slow, hold it. Quick, quick, hold it. Quick, quick, hold it. And that's particularly important on these moves. Slow, quick, quick, hold it. Quick, quick, hold it. Quick, quick, hold it. It's just tempting to want to run. You're like, you're thinking, well, I want to get through that step and to jump it, right? If you jump it, the timing gets off, right? So you got time to do that. Okay, one other thing I wanted to point out regarding the lead, just to emphasize again, in order to help with that pivot, the leader should put a fair amount of pressure, not forcing it, but a fair amount, you want firm contact with the shoulder blade because you're using that for steerage. And you also want, in taking this step forward, you want to sort of unwind the body, right? So slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow. Let's do that again. Sometimes it doesn't go quite right. Slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow,
yeah,
right? So given the combination of this, and as always, we're keeping the frame firm, right? So we're not moving the arm separately from this, all coming around. So even should the follower be not particularly proficient in the step, she's gonna get in the right place because the leader is gonna make sure she gets there. And then you can just pick up the rhythm and keep going, which is a good general rule, by the way. Always, always dance through. If you mess up and you need to stop and start over, nothing wrong with that. Happens all the time on the dance floor. Okay, so now we're just gonna dance through, if I remember them correctly, all of the steps we've done so far. I'm gonna put the music on. This is a smooth operator by Saad, by the way.
Smooth operator.
High stakes, making hot stakes.
it for today.